there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode here on Pastiche of Skin. Today we're doing another unboxing, but this time a little bit different than usual. We have Amazon.
Here,
yes, we have Amazon.
Here.
And
there,
we also have
Terry Crews.
We also have at Real World Comedy sitting here to join us. This is a special box because this is actually me buying some new stuff to do review videos here on the channel.
This is new content. This is gonna be
this
fun.
Is new content. So this is new content. This is old content describing new content as we look at the things that are going to be in the new content, and we actually start doing a little cool little experiments with the gear that I'm going to be picking up. Yeah. I've got myself in a situation where I want to actually kind of upgrade some stuff that I have. So I've gone to Amazon and I've actually picked up some third party, probably on the level of knockoff quality camera gear to play with. So we're going to take a look inside this box. So, Will, take her away. Get this thing open.
Batman will open the box.
Na 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 box cutter. Na 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 box cutter. Na 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 box cutter.
Batman.
Wait, you don't want to do is
cut
your box.
Cut.
The other type of box.
Oh yeah, no. Be careful with the G-string as well. Is there actually stuff inside the box? Oh, he actually cut through the both of them. Okay, so what we got actually the first.
One thing.
Oh, yeah. What's the first thing we got out of the box there?
We have the panorama camera. Yeah, this is this is actually the one I have. I have this bad boy.
You have this one?
I own this camera, actually.
Oh, cool.
So, funny enough, I can't find it. So, hopefully it didn't.
Does it work? That's the more important question.
It does. It works. It's not too bad. It's, you know, with 360 cameras, it's the focus on them aren't that great.
Because
they're doing like a lot. So I mean,
it's 360 by 190 is the actual range. Like, so it's 190 angle. You're chatting like that much in view, but all the way around.
Well, the fact is, I have one. You have one now.
We know you actually have
full 360 range. No.
Yeah, you have a band, so with the 360 by 190, you have a band that goes around your head, essentially, that has stops here and stops here. By putting the two of them together, you end up having two bands that can overlap and actually can make a globe.
Mm-hmm.
So we could, and with the two of them together, it actually could work. See, one of the reasons why I was looking at this is because of the Wi-Fi capability to mobile devices. Have you tested that on yours?
I've tested it on my iPod.
Yeah.
It's a little choppy.
The playback to the Wi-Fi is just for the purposes of actually being able to monitor.
And there
the
is
time.
A delay. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Being a monitor and a delay. But.
Oh, you got the black one. I got the blue one.
Oh, I didn't even choose my color. I didn't have a choice.
To be fair.
Because
I thought I was getting the yellow one.
All these items are actually the Amazon Warehouse. Have you ever used Amazon Warehouse?
No.
So essentially what Amazon Warehouse is, it's pre-displayed, pre-used, but pre-displayed items. Or items
Amazon
that
have been
publicly damaged, just, you know, like they've been water damaged or light damaged or whatever else, you know, like kind of faded.
Well, this is why then this box has got a little bit of damage there.
Yeah, it's intentional. But the reason why I go shopping on Amazon Warehouse is because this stuff's guaranteed the same as anything else on Amazon.
Yep.
But it's always at least half the price.
Too bad.
And you just browse through it. It's literally one of those things. It's like going into the dirt mall and just digging through the boxes, and sometimes you find something really cool. And the case, this was literally a third of its normal price of about 80, 90 pounds. I got it for $24.
Nice. I got mine at about 50 quid at the time, so not too bad.
So they, they weren't on offer at the time, so I got a decent discount on them. And I hope there actually is a decent functionality in this. So I'm assuming it's a micro USB charge, is it?
Micro USB charger.
Can you take the battery out?
You cannot.
Are you sure, even with taking the backup rule off this?
No. There's taking the battery out, and then there's taking the device apart to take the battery out. There is a difference.
Right, so it does run on its own internal battery. But the one thing I would say with it being, it's so tiny, just show it to people actually, because this is so tiny. Being able to charge it through a USB port means that I'll be able to run an external battery to that, so I'll be able to use it for much longer than its prescribed length. That's the one thing. Pass me the sleeve for it again there. Because I want to check to see what stats are written on the back of this. So, while you're showing that there, its lens is 360 degrees by 190 on an f2.0.
Standard connector for, you know, your light stand, your tripod, or all that.
Quarter-inch thread, yeah.
there is your micro USB port and your micro SD card port.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if I remember correctly, I don't think mine actually has the wee holes around the side of that.
Speaker or microphone?
Yeah, I can't remember if mine has it or not, but I know when you've got this seal over, you have to be waterproof in it.
Well, I'd say water resistant.
You can get a case for it.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty. And it's not cheap plastic, not the fucking light shit you find on like some plastic toys.
Do you know what it reminds me of? Have you seen the Polaroid Instagram thing, camera?
Yeah, the 360 one.
The wee cube one. It looks like a knockoff of that.
That is pretty much, you know.
That's what it is,
It is a knockoff of that one. Only, you know, not fucking
proprietary branded.
£200 dearer.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. That's what the whole point is. Whenever you're buying this kind of thing, you just accept that there's like probably a level of quality and build that's reduced for that better saving. But these are like designed to just be the exact same device. So let me go through the technical specs here that are written on the back. So it's 1280 by 1024. So it's not true 1080. It's 1024. It is SVGA. SVGA is 1280 by 1024. So it's not quite. It's HD. It's over 720, but it's below 1080.
The resolution 1024.
So it is HD, but it's not.
It's high def. Some people wouldn't notice the difference.
But the problem is, that's high def in 360 degrees. So that's not an ultra high def, not even a super high def, just not barely high def image spread across on a much larger scale. So
the funny thing is,
that's where the blurring and stuff actually
You've already seen the quality of this.
Yeah.
I've sent you files.
Mm-hmm.
Now for this specific camera here. Oh, better. When you've got that uploaded, you need to use software to put the metadata on. So if you upload it to something like YouTube,
mm-hmm.
or not YouTube, well yeah, YouTube and Facebook, especially using the touch screen to go around, you'll actually have to add better content.
But all that metadata can be done in Premiere Pro as well.
Yes, for those who know Premiere Pro.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I don't.
Well, for me, that's my intention is that I'll be stitching and using this footage
like
together.
The fact that it looks like an eye. That's one perk I've always liked about this camera.
It looks
like
someone
ripped the fucking Johnny Five eye socket or something.
Yeah, yeah,
or
yeah.
Wally. No, because mine's yellow, I think Wally.
Oh, yeah, I suppose like the wee replaceable units he has in his head. So what else we got to rest of down here? Network connection is wireless BG, or so essentially it's Wi-Fi BG or N. So that means it works with pretty much nearly any device. Battery, 1300 milliamps. So the 3100 milliamps built-in battery is what? It'll probably run for 3 to 4 hours on that?
Depending on the memory card, I would get about 2 hours out of it, but if you run it continuously off USB, via battery or power, it'll record until your memory card's full.
Yeah, yeah. No, I imagine that would be the case. I wouldn't...
And I think, if I remember correctly, I think I recorded about 2 hours, and it was about maybe 500 megabytes
just 500 meg for 2 hours.
Well, maybe
maybe
it was closer to a gig. Because I think it split the video up in half.
I'm tempted to find out if there's actually a functional kind of photography setup, or like instead of it actually being video only, if it does time lapse as a series of JPEGs. Because if it does time lapse as a series of JPEGs, it could be a much higher resolution image. But I'll need to tweak around with this and see if it actually does that functionality.
I'll definitely have to check the
manual inside this bit.
The manual.
And, of course, max two devices can connect it via Wi-Fi. There is an audio mic on this. It does a standard camera interface for a quarter-inch screw, so it just goes onto any hot shoe mount. And,
Is your memory?
Yeah, TF or micro USB.
Yeah.
You're very unlikely to see that pinhole. The wee pinhole mic in the front of it. I mean, all I would use that pinhole mic for is syncing. I would never, ever use the audio from something like that.
Yeah.
I'd use it for sync. External audio, I'd use it for sync. I've got that many audio equipment gear sitting here. Like, I mean, even you hear us talking now, we're using our external gear.
Yep.
That's pretty cool. I'm actually happy with the first thing that we actually have in here.
You get a nice bit of accessories with it, too.
Is there actually, like, accessory kit?
Yeah.
What is in here?
All the standard stuff, you know, head
mounts right.
and all that
head
you
mounts.
Know, especially on bikes. Or a mount for, I think, handlebars. possibly.
Yeah, I mean, some of these standard mounts actually make it easier for us to even mount it to our rigging that we have here in the studio. So we could be able to, we could actually be using this, if I can get it connected to the Wi-Fi through, say, a wee Linux box and actually set that up as a studio camera, that'd be kind of cool. I would like to have that running perpetually as a studio camera, just broadcasting whenever I get the RMTP server up. That'd be kind of cool.
I'll let you deal with that technical stuff.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're building an RMTP server. It's not that big of a deal. It's just so that way you can broadcast in multiple streams in the future. So we can do to Twitch, we can do to YouTube, we can do to Facebook, we can do to Hitbox, we can do to all those all at the exact same time, rather than just doing it through one.
Nothing else in there?
It's all bell clips, all the same normal stuff. Like you said, straps, head straps, sticky pads, a lens cleaner, manual. And that's all. Like, it's the usual kind of like kiddling bits that you get from an action camera.
Download this app, and it's a,
is it really?
It almost because this is a third party. The app's almost like a third party app too. It's like it's very basic. The app's very basic. You just connect to such and such, put in a password, blah blah, and that's it.
So I like the fact
it's a nice wee bit of kit. Like you get it, you mess around enough, and you'll get the desired footage you want from it. I've only ever used this, I walked around the town with it, I had the wrong setting, so it looked very weird when I played it back, but once you get used to it, you'll understand that you record it, and it's like 180, 190, whatever, 360.
360 by 190.
But it's only going to properly work if you use it on something that will let you access the 360. You can't watch it on a laptop.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you've uploaded it to a website.
Aye.
Like I've uploaded my content to Facebook. Because it's a Facebook, I can you can click on it, you can move it around, you can look about, all that sort of thing.
Or if you're using a mobile phone device, you can literally move around and use the JavaScript.
Yeah, like if you're a headset, just But if you just upload the raw video footage to Facebook, Facebook won't recognize it as you need that data. Like you said, you can put it on Adobe, or you can do a bit of there's free software for it, and that'll attach it to it. So once you upload it to Facebook,
it'll stitch the two ends. Literally, what it does is it grabs the two ends and stitches the two together. And says this is the beginning, this is the end, and does a lap. That's essentially what, and then it understands its context from that. So yeah, we're going to be playing with this camera. We're going to be playing with all these cameras and showing some footage to you guys here on the channel in not that long time. We're going to be using it tonight for the first time. But the whole intention is to actually have something up within a week to actually kind of review the device, talk about its foibles, about its skill sets. I mean, you've actually already got experience with it, so I'd actually really appreciate your input whenever I come to actually like looking back over the footage and stuff. So yeah, we got our first little gift inside the box cleared out of the way. Cool. You want to move on to the next thing?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Let's move on. There's a clamp. What? Or a strap on.
Fine.
Always do it with a strap on, folks.
Always strap it in, strap it on, and strap it up.
Ooh, we got paper.
Paper. Who cares about paper? The paper. Yeah, paper.
Standard fine black pen nibs.
Ah, man.
Derb needs these so bad, it's unreal.
I do need my nibs. Give me my nibs.
Also, I feel like you could probably use the pen, the screen without the actual pen. If you just had nibs secretly stashed around your recording area.
No, the thing is, you understand how the nibs work on these. So, if you guys have never noticed, I actually use a Cintiq for control of the broadcast whenever I'm actually recording. It's just the way I've always done these videos. I've had a Cintiq 12WX for years, and it is beaten into shit. It's really, really not going to last much longer. But one of the main things that happens is the wee pen nibs that you have go like that whenever you're using them. So that's why I bought a set of pen nibs, which, now looking at them, look to be the wrong size. Yeah, doesn't cover for this, because it actually lists for all the different N2S pens, but this actually doesn't fit for this pen.
Wow.
So I have to actually buy another set of these.
That sucks serious, Paul.
Yeah, and the thing is, you can't use them without the pen, because the way this works is that it puts pressure on a wee sensor on the inside, and that tells you the degree of pressure you're actually pressing into it.
Sure, definitely gonna fit.
They look about the same, but they're slightly slimmer.
Which one, what's your...
The 12WX. It's on the back.
No, it is not.
Yeah.
No, it is not.
So, we may have to buy another set. The thing is, like, they don't make this 12WX anymore. Once this thing's dead, I am... up shit creek because I cannot afford to buy a replacement one of these screens. This one was donated very, very kindly by an animator friend of mine. She was amazing. She actually got her, she got one just before she got this one as a gift from somebody else, and then passed it on to me. And then she's upgraded since then, so she's actually moved on from her WX, which I think gave up the ghost a couple of years ago.
Back in the box.
Back in the box for you. You're getting posted back. Right. Put these down here. Get this out of the way.
Okay,
what do we got next?
Here. Not fairly sure what that is.
It's inside an anti-static bag. I'm perturbed because it's in an anti-static bag. Oh yeah, cool. Alright, so this is the new webcam.
Oh, right, okay.
So what we use currently on our main webcam here at the front is a Logitech C920. Was it 920 or 922? A Logitech C920, which is a, it's like an almost an industry standard for YouTubers. It is like the one that everybody uses at some point. Maximilian Dude uses two of them for his cooking, for his wife's cooking show or girlfriend's cooking show. Most of the guys who do the face cam, like just like focused in, use the C920.
Oh, that's the one you were.
Yeah, this is the one that arrived in the post.
That like a bag. Poor... that's not fucking.
It's a very fancy bag for what appears to be a very cheap webcam. But the point is that, as you can see, we're using... as you can see...
as you can, yeah.
The quality from my secondary camera here in the office is awful. That is actually a PlayStation iToy from the PS2 era, or PS3. PS3 era, that I've actually been using with modified drivers for the last, I don't know... you love your little handbag. I've been using it with modified drivers for the last maybe year and a half, 2 years. And I had this was whenever I first did my YouTube channel, doing gaming videos. Like, if you go back and look at the really early Pastiche of Play games,
the video quality
was from that. And it wasn't brilliant in any way, shape, or form, but it worked.
You'd wonder why they would give you this. You know,
is there anything else in it?
There's nothing else in it. It's got a bit of a hardback in the center there.
Well, the reason why is because this is probably an awful, awful camera. That'd be the reason why. so, yeah, like, if you want to take a wee quick look at that. So, the big thing is, it's 12 megapixel. I've got a feeling that is not 12 megapixel. I've got a feeling that is actually 1.2. If that's a 12 megapixel camera, I'll be fucking delighted. So, the main thing with getting the camera was... getting a new camera was
there's enough fucking USB cable on it.
That's one of the reasons why I got it as well. Extremely long USB. It looks kind of cool. It's got this nice chrome kind of, like, you were chatting about Johnny Five earlier on. It looks more Johnny Five headed.
Beady.
Like, is that Battlestar Galactica or what was that?
That's Buck Rogers.
Buck Rogers, yeah. Beady. The camera itself actually has a manual focus ring, which is fucking important whenever you're doing broadcasts like this, because...
I gotta admit, actually, I'm trying to use them. It's a little bit awkward.
Yeah, well, it's a really awkward position for it. You're going to set it once and then never set it again. So my intention is, if it equals the quality of my 920 and has a manual focus ring, I may use it more than the actual 920, and then the 920 would be relegated to a secondary camera or an alternate angle, just give me a different idea of someone I can work with, because it could be mounted onto a microphone stand or onto any stand that actually takes a quarter head screw, but this has to be like clamped to something. So if the quality is good and I have the right focus for it and I actually have the throw distance that it's required, I might actually be putting that as this main camera that I'll be looking to you guys for in the future with a little bit more versatility.
I mean, I know it's a bit jerky there, but it's kind of solid. Once you close it, you know it's not going to flick back open, you know?
That's the thing. You have to yank at that probably to get it to pull. It feels like a standard solid camera, doesn't it?
I do like the design. I got to admit, I love the design because it looks like a CCTV camera.
Yes.
If anything, it'll make people paranoid.
Yeah, if they see it in the room, because it is literally the Eye of Sauron staring at you. But the thing is, do you know what the biggest deal about that camera is? Less than 20 quid.
Less than 20 quid. If this... has the quality, this got the quality of the camera we're shooting in right now, the one I'm pointing at you there, then I can see you buying, for 100 quid you can buy 5 of these and have a really good studio setup.
Do you know how much you would get of those for 100 quid?
One?
Yep.
And a quarter?
If even.
That.
Because you'd probably go and get, you wouldn't even get the 920 anymore, you get the 922 or the 930. So yeah, that what I'm trying to do is I'm going to get a few of these webcams and just line them up side by side and just do a series of videos where you get to see what they are that's laid across from each other. Because I think a lot of people go for this camera because so many other people have it, but it's not quite worth it in my opinion. So we'll see what this draws.
No instructions with it?
None.
No instructions. Yep. Plug and play, USB, hope to God. I mean, I'm looking at it and I'm hoping that these holes here, I don't know which one they're going to be, but there's holes in each of the corners.
Mm-hmm.
I can only hope one of those is like maybe a built-in
mic. Oh yeah, it's got a built-in mic. But I mean, we're never, ever, ever using the microphone quality from one of those fucking cameras.
No, that's right. I would say this one, just because...
It looks like a deeper dot?
There's like a weak glint. Like a glint of something in there.
That might actually be the pinhole camera where the goddamn lens actually is, because that metal bit doesn't look like there's an actual lens in there.
No, there's something in there.
Mm. Yeah. So yeah, we've got a new camera to be working with.
Camera Uno 2! Numero uno two, sorry.
Yes, so we're looking at this here.
For our Spanish viewers.
Our throw distance, so it's an f-stop 2.0 with a minimum throw distance of 4.8 millimeters, which means it's essentially macro. You could actually be shooting it like that.
Yeah, close.
That close. Which is kind of cool. Look forward to giving it a try. For a 12 megapixel camera that shoots in 1080p HD and it
does
works.
Macro?
What?
Does macro?
And does macro. This could be very interesting. We will see very soon whenever we test this out.
Well, we do have a box of pins that if it is proper macro, we're fine for that.
Yeah, we might just use it for that particular reason. But this feels solid and useful. Is there an actual brand name on this?
No, just as patent number. So
there is a number here, a serial number. So if you want to find this particular model of whatever this goddamn camera is, it's referred to as a 187Y3 1080p HD camera.
Unless, there's a brand on the front, but unless you... speak Japanese or Chinese or something, I don't know.
Well, I'm not even thinking that. I don't think that actually is even a brand. I think it's just literally a thing.
I think it's a brand,
but there is a quality assurance in this, so that's this is going to be one of our new cameras. And if it does take off well, you will see multi-camera setups like a billion on this. Whenever
we'll just
they
be all
work.
Like, we'll have them and we can.
Hey!
No, I was thinking we could all go.
Do you know what we could actually do? We could build a bullet time camera Matrix. System. We could do the bullet time camera system. We get enough of them lined up around each other. That'd be fucking doing that with a webcam. Oh man!
I think I hurt myself when I was laughing there.
We could actually do 3D modeling with like 25 of these.
Nice. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens.
If people create this and like our review, feel free to send us 25 of them. We've got ideas.
Oh yeah, and a green screen. 25 cameras, green screen. What could go wrong? We know what could go right, but what could go wrong? Everything could go wrong.
I'm just looking at different places we could actually mount this thing. It could be amazing.
We have one more camera left.
Yep.
Numero uno trois?
Numero uno trois?
Yeah, a bit of French. French for our Mexican
three.
Listeners.
And we, numero uno. So number one, three? Number 13? Tres?
Yes. Uno, dos.
Tres.
Hey, look, I only know a bit of Mexican from the last ketchup song.
Yes, I'm sure that's exactly what we call it. We call it the Mexican language.
Yeah. I think you've been Spanish or something.
Yeah.
Okay, so, we've got
the Vemico.
Vemico! Vemico! I feel like it's a Mexican wrestler.
Yeah, so.
Wow, a lot of Mexicans in it. 4K Sport.
Yeah.
Full HD on it.
Well, 4K full HD.
Water resistant to 40 meters.
So it is an action camera. This obviously is a GoPro knockoff action camera. Same model, same shape. Very similar to the Yi Cam, which has been around for a fair amount of time. This one is a 4K model. I wanted a 4K camera to try and test out with. Is it even picking that up at all? Is it showing the contents? So what I wanted to have was a 4K camera that could maybe be used to replace the webcams because you can run a feed directly from these to a PC, either via HDMI or via USB. The fisheye lens is a problem, but whenever you shoot in 4K, if I center my image correctly, I can actually crop the fisheye.
Yes.
And still be able to use it perfectly fine. So a cropped 4K image is still 1080p, so it could be a much sharper choice rather than actually what we've been having with the other cameras.
we should just keep the fisheye as it is. You mean like
what do the fisheye kind of thing?
Fish market is a completely untapped niche market that we could totally go for.
Yeah, because they actually, for once, they would actually be looking at the TV screen, going like, "I can see it."
Do you remember like Def Clark made an entire album on water for the aquatic creatures of the sea?
I'm sure they did. Yeah, and that
Mermaider is definitely a brilliant tune there. yeah. We couldn't get any further away from the point we're making.
Anyway. Yeah, no, you can't get further away from it. I'm literally reading specs of a goddamn camera.
You can read specs, and I'll just keep. I'll just take the Batman
our options. There are options with this camera. So the image sensor in it is a Sony IMX 179 16 megapixel CMOS sensor.
Open it.
Does that make any sense to you? Was that just numbers and letters, or were actual words?
They were blurry words and letters to me.
Okay, and so numbers even. By what it implies with Sony IMX 179, there was Sony action cams. They used to be like those little rounded ones you could drop to the side of your head.
Yes.
Action cameras.
Yes.
This is a knockoff of a GoPro that's using a Sony sensor.
So it's a Sony camera?
It is actually a Sony camera. It is it's a knockoff of a Sony camera, but in the body shape of one of the GoPros.
One of the most popular fucking brands out there.
The popular recognizable shape of one. Oh, good grief. Well, plenty of accessories as well.
Oh, yeah. Up the wazoo.
So, I'll let you have a wee look at this and show it to our audience. And no, give me the box. I need that.
Oh, hi.
Thank you. So, having the check out of it, obviously looks exactly like every other GoPro that's on the planet. Every Yeecam, every knockoff you're going to get. But with the Sony IMX sensor, it's going to be... one of the things that people always comment with the Sony was stability... And clarity
the micro,
was so much better.
USB port.
Yep, they all be on that same side. So what this camera can do is 4K at 30 frames per second, 2.7K at 30 frames per second, 1080p at 60 or 30. So you can actually get really, really smooth 1080p out of this. Now, a smooth 60 frame per second 1080p would be really nice to actually use for the stream. Because I find that I've actually purposely limited the gameplay footage I have to 30, while the video footage from me has been in 30. And if I can actually have 260 frames per second sources to work with, I would probably upgrade the stream and actually probably do it like so you get better clarity, better fluidity of movement on it, other than getting some of this jerkiness or motion blur that you would see.
Oh yeah.
And also with the 60 frames per second, it would make the keying for our green screen so much easier in the future too. It also can do 720p at 90, 60, and 30, so it does do slow-mo. It doesn't have 120 frames per second to super slow-mo, which is disappointing. It's one of those things where I've always seen that actually being like an action cam choice, and it made them more useful for those action situations. But I'm not going to use it for this purpose. It is an action cam, but I'm not going to be using it in that particular way.
It's an action cam, but it's not for the action you want.
Yeah. So, now, photo mode...
What was the price on this?
So, this camera was £40.
£40?
Yeah.
The Idover VAC, there is a Vivitar camera you can buy in your local Currys or Argos or whoever, or online. And I got one, £50. £50. And it does not, at the time I got it, it was not 4K.
Yeah.
Full HD, whatever. Probably because the battery's not on.
But not the battery's in it.
No, because this is an accessory. You get a spare battery. See, I can read a box. It is.
Yeah, there's a spare battery here.
But you get...
Tiny battery.
You didn't get a... There's no screen on it. There's no built-in screen.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. There it is. You can show it. We can actually show them the PS3...
camera in the flat in the reflection of it.
In the reflection of the screen of the.
That's creepy.
Yeah.
It looks like a monster with those two glowing eyes.
Looks like Evil Johnny 5.
Yeah.
Or, police version. The police cop version.
the police cop. I love those police cops. They cop and police at
police
once.
Police story. It was a good film.
It was actually. The original police story and the new police story was actually pretty good as well.
Oh, it's not. It's the HD output. I was looking at, I couldn't actually see the SD card slot at the time.
Yeah.
When I had it in the case.
So that's what I'm saying. I can actually be able to, with a capture card, I can run a HDMI signal from this camera straight into my PC. Which I'd be doing with my capture devices anyway. I was going to be setting this up for a DSLR.
Very light. It is a very light camera. Not to say the quality of the build, that's not good, but yeah, I suppose it's probably just because of that.
Well, it's just that, I mean, they actually, you've held GoPros before, haven't you?
Yep.
They're light cameras. They actually are, they're intentionally light because they're a thin LCD screen, they're a camera sensor, and a lens, and that's literally it. That's all that's in these motherfuckers. Maybe a Wi-Fi connection as well. This, that's the one thing this camera does not have.
No Wi-Fi?
No Wi-Fi for, it doesn't have Wi-Fi for, oh, wait, no, I'm lying out of my balls.
Liar!
Do you know the reason why
would you lie to us?
Do you know the reason why? Because it's actually covered by the label for Amazon Warehouse. And it's a range of up to 10 meters where you can actually be able to use this as a Wi-Fi connective camera. The app for it is actually shown on the side. You know, you see the QR code on the side of it.
Yes,
that's how you get. That's how you get the app. You scan that with your phone, and your phone will automatically download the app. On the other side, yeah.
Oh no, I've seen that on the other side.
So for iOS or Android, either way, this can be connectivity to use with it.
But I've activated something. Software was like, oh, must download this now.
Oh, great! Thanks very much. That'd be really nice of you. So, yeah. This is the piece de resistance. This is the one I was excited to get to try out. Portable 4K cameras are plentiful now, but ones that actually have a decent, accurate, representative image and shoot at a high enough frame rate, and got a decent functionality, are a bit few and far between. So I'm looking forward to trying this bad boy out. Take that. So obviously the one issue that this camera will have is its micro size batteries. So, what is it? 900 milliamp hours per battery. So 900, you're chatting 20 to 30 minutes.
What? A way off?
You have to make a loss somewhere, man.
But that's the thing. We're going to be using this for something completely different. Because an action cam is for action. It's for something that happens in minutes.
Yeah.
In seconds. It's not for something that's...
You turned it on for a run down a mountain.
We're not... Yeah. You know, what's that? How long it took him to jump out of the airplane and go skydiving and shit? 20 minutes?
Well, it's for use with a parachute. It's not for use with a squirrel suit. That's what the difference is.
You remember that, Marvel, when you're making Squirrel Girl?
Oh, yeah, no, I'd love to see a Squirrel Girl movie. But yeah, as usual, the typical, normal lunacy of every connective point you can possibly have that sinks into other points.
I've just taken this off bottom. This is the one thing I hate about these cases is... You've got to have this fucking little shitty goddamn thing down here, and if that busts or breaks, that's the case. Fuck. I mean, it'll still keep it waterproof, but it means then you can't attach something to it.
There's no mounts for it.
Yeah. Wow. I did not expect to get angry about that.
Well, I mean, you've got full right to get angry because you're a man who actually makes sure to mount everything, but.
Yes. Yes, I am. If it moves, I'll mount it.
If it moves, I'll mount it and make sure it never moves again.
Careful now. That's getting awfully weird. Anyway.
Hey, you said it first. But I mean, as always, the mad accessory kit of lunacy with all these straps and different ways. Oh, actually.
To be fair, if you're smart, just get a
spare alternate door. So if you break the hinge or break the door, you have a spare.
Well, that's... Oh, okay, that's nice.
That's nice. That's a nice touch.
You get a spare.
I'm just looking here to see what else there is. Bunch of zip ties.
Bunch of red
shirt. I mean, there's everything in here. There is a manual that's at the bottom of this. And get to it. Even that.
Oh, the wee stickies.
No, the wee wire. You can, like, tie it to something in case it gets lost. So, like, if it falls away. So, with the user manual right here, 4K, FHD, 16 megapixel, Wi-Fi, waterproof up to 40 meters inside its case, and... A very simple diagram and example of everything that's inside these boxes, how you're meant to use them together, how to hook it up to a bike helmet, how to use it on your belt hoop, guides for operating, on your hoop, get it on your hoop before you're on your hoop.
I am Lacutus of Action Cam.
Resistance is futile?
Resistance is
acceptable.
Oh yeah.
So software upgrades, you can actually upgrade the firmware of this camera. Oh, so it says it's actually F2.0 on the camera, but it's actually F2.8. Hey, that's the thing when you start reading through the manuals, you know, there's a mild difference.
Yeah.
Dimensions, weight, batteries, okay. And 100, yeah, so it is a fisheye lens, so it has 170 degrees angle view. But it actually has a lesser angle than the 360 cam, but I mean, that's essentially a fisheye lens, you know. And
they're just gonna strap all three of these cameras together and see what three convoluted fucked up 363
images. We just throw it in the air and see what happens. it turns into like a black hole and just sucks up all life inside of it. It does do time lapse.
Like marriage.
It does do time lapse in 1, 2, 5, 10, 30, and 60 second intervals. So I'm looking forward to doing some time lapse footage with this in 4K. Time lapse in 4K for pan and scan.
God help us.
Man, you shot your bridge stuff in 1080, wasn't it?
Yeah. So HDR as well.
HDR 1080. So you imagine actually having 4K HDR to actually be able to do time lapse stuff and then be able to actually zoom into 1080 level and then be able to pan and move around the image while it's actually time lapsing.
Ooh, that would be cool.
Yeah.
That said, you would definitely need to strap this to an external power source.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, and the easiest thing to do is just through the USB. It'll run perfectly fine. It does have a micro USB, right?
What other cables are there?
There is no micro USB in here.
No, not that.
Oh, there is.
Remember I highlighted the part where...
It's got a micro HDMI.
It's got a HDMI output there.
Yeah, it's got a micro HDMI. I own here micro HDMI cables.
That's fucking tiny.
Yeah, micro.
No. It's smaller than micro. It's like, that's an odd square one.
Okay. It is HDMI, right?
Yep. See on
it? HD out. Then, is that it? No, that's a USB. It's a USB cable. So we don't actually get a cable to connect it to HDMI in it.
It's like a TV.
Like that. That's a nice touch.
Vemico! Because, why not?
Because why the fuck not? Yeah, so I'll take a wee dig through this to see if there's anything else inside these of worthwhile note. But, I mean, most of this is actually obviously normal kind of kibbles and bits.
Maybe that go alongside this will get you. You know, the external, you know, if you want the live, you know, if you want the preview.
Use the live straight out of it. Yeah, it would actually be a problem. Out. I suppose it could be an issue. I mean, that's what the way I'm trying to do. But, I mean, essentially, we've got... It doesn't even say anything about the HDMI in this manual. That's the main problem I'm actually having here. Well, sorry, I'm actually into the German bits now. I'm going to check and see if it actually says it's maybe in multiple languages, you know, like normal European kind of thing. Checking to see here if there is one that actually says ribbons, wire cables, data cable. Nope, just data cable. Nothing to say about the HDMI port in it. So the HD out in it, I'm obviously going to have to pick up a cable for that.
Oh,
which is kind of interesting. What? Oh yeah, it's a cage without the actual external, so you can mount it onto a screw.
Yeah, but I feel like that'd be like if you bought like four of them and strapped them together, or you could cage it together.
Yeah, if I got four of them, I would actually just get a 3D printed cage for them. Because you can actually buy it. You can actually just get one. Buy. You can actually print a 3D print yourself an actual box that actually holds four or five GoPros or these cameras together, so that you can actually then use them for stitching 360 footage together. It's if you want to check it out, look up Sam and Nico. They actually like showed them printing out one of those and then having to reprint it again because something went horribly wrong, and then going through all the aches and pains of trying to create 360 video using that same device. So yeah, I think that's
good, because we can strap to multiple. You know, you can strap it above a top and bottom.
I can actually have. No, here's the thing.
Fucking things around.
You can mount a light to that now.
Ah, well that's yeah.
Yeah.
Because the body itself actually has no... There's no actual standard screw anywhere on this.
So you actually use that cage for it, and then you'd be able to... And what I would use that cage for, say, for example, if I was doing nightclub photography.
Yep.
I would actually go out, do night photography, I would actually have a flash on my person, I would have the camera I was using, and I'd be able to record video through that at the same time, and be able to record a 4K footage of the entire event and the entire night while using my camera to flash and take photographs of people along the way. So it's just the fact that there's a lot of utility in that 4K camera that I've just bought, even though it is for the purpose of review and testing for this kind of channel, but I'm going to find a use out of that. Also notice those two batteries are different capacities.
Oh, do they?
Uh-huh. You want to look at that? Well, one of them's, I think, 900 and the other one's 1,000. So I think that's what the main difference between the pair of them actually is.
Yeah,
the 50. So it's one of those things where I end up going on to the we have to actually just say goodnight for the rest of the show. And we end up the we're doing live broadcast. Sorry. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. We've had a small interruption as we've been going through the last of these parcels. I'll end up actually letting you guys get on, and thank you very much for watching us here as we unboxed a few of the cameras that we're going to be checking out here on the reviews on the channel in the near future. So thanks very much. It's goodbye from me. That's goodbye from...
Goodbye from me. Give us a thumbs up.
Thank you very much for watching. And of course, if you enjoyed watching us talking about this stuff, come back to the channel whenever we do the reviews in the next week or so. And of course, hit the subscribe button. It'll be floating around somewhere on here, maybe even right over the top of my face or over the top of his face. And you'll actually be able to subscribe to the channel, see any of the videos as they come out here on YouTube. And if you want to check out the other ones that are floating around the screen somewhere around you, you'll be able to see other stuff that we worked on really recently. So thank you very much for watching. And I will see all you dudes in the next video. Bye.
Bye.